Welcome to the Powerful Marketing Tips Podcast, created for overwhelmed business owners who want to build, run, and organize their marketing for good. And here's a brief overview of our guest. Get ready to meet a globally recognized LinkedIn Pages expert who has been using LinkedIn Pages to help businesses grow for 8 years already. Michelle J. Raymond is the chief LinkedIn strategist at her company, Good Trading Company, and is a founding member of the LinkedIn Small Business Advisory Council for Pages. She's also the co-author of a book on LinkedIn company pages called Business Gold. In this interview, she'll share her best tips on how to utilize LinkedIn company pages to build a strong business brand. So if you've been wondering whether or why you should be on LinkedIn and how to build a following there, then this interview is a must listen for you.
Hello. So today we will talk about LinkedIn company pages, how to utilize one to really build this strong business brand. And I could not be more excited to have Michelle Raymond, the global expert, here with us today. Welcome, Michelle.
Hi, it's so great to be here. Global expert, I love that. And I really, you know, for me, company pages are my thing. So I can't wait to share that with all of your audience as well.
Wow, amazing. So tell us, please, how you ended up focusing on company pages at LinkedIn, because I have to be honest with you, I am not sure how much value even people have seen around LinkedIn pages, you know, especially company pages, because same really goes for myself here.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. And people think I'm a little bit crazy, and that's all right. You know, I've had this conversation many times. And essentially, you know, how I got into it was almost by accident. So what happened was I set my business up to help. I come from the beauty industry. I was very well known in using LinkedIn for social selling in that industry. I came across to set up my own business. And with that, what I actually did was I decided that I would go and do LinkedIn training with, you know, with the people in my industry. So I went out to the first business owner that I knew and I said to them, I've written this amazing training program. I can show you exactly how I've sold millions of dollars worth of things using LinkedIn. All you have to do is sit with me for 2 hours and you'll have it too. And they just said this look on their face of, oh my God, Michelle, how do you think we're going to do that as well? We are small business owners. We are doing everything. We are the general manager. We are HR. We are the accountant. We are, you know, doing everything all day, every day. Where do you think I have time to do LinkedIn as well? And then one of them turned around and she said to me, you're really good at it. Can't you just do it for us? And I was like, what do you mean? She goes, I'll just pay you to do it. And I was like, I don't know how that would work. I'd only ever used it for myself. And so I looked into it and I discovered that with company pages, one of the great advantages of them is that you're actually able to subcontract out the page admin. So you can actually get someone else to do it for you. And so every time I went to a new company and said, here's my training, they just went, can't you do it for us? And so it became like that. And I just saw the need for small business owners who basically my ideal clients say this to me. They say, Michelle, I know we should, but, and it's normally no time, no resources. And sometimes they don't even want to do it. They could be really good subject matter experts, but not want to do social media, you know, and unfortunately, you know, when you're a business owner, you get to do everything. So that's kind of how it started. Over time, I realized if I looked back at my career in sales, so I'd been, you know, selling for 20 years. I started using LinkedIn around 8 years to help me in those sales roles. I built up a really huge personal brand. And then what would happen was I got poached to go to another company and work for a competitor. And then I took all of my personal branding with me, and that company had nothing left in its place. And then I left the next company because another opportunity came. They also got, you know, left with nothing in its place. And that's when I realized it's really important not only to build your employees' brands, but to also make sure that you're building your company brand as well. And that's where company pages fits into my story. And when I looked around, no one else was talking about them back, you know, 12 months ago when I started this journey. I realized that we had this need from business owners, but there was no one actually out there to help them. And so that's where I've begun my LinkedIn journey in my business for the last, you know, almost 12 months now, is helping other people get the most out of them. So yeah, super exciting, but not really popular.
Yeah, but that's a great journey you just told us, because it really is like those business owners who are there doing all of those things inside their business, they don't have time to work with different pages inside the company. But you brought out a very good, very important actually thing, you know. It's not only to work on your personal brand, because people can leave you with their brand pretty much. So tell us a little bit, those company pages, why are they important to have one?
Look, there's a couple of really basic levels. So if we start at the very beginning on the foundation, the reason that I say to people that you need one, even if you don't post content, it only takes 15 to 30 minutes to set up a free company page. Now, I recommend that everybody does that, even if you don't do content, because number one, if someone searches for your business name on Google, which is, you know, the world's biggest search engine, LinkedIn results always show on the first page for your business name, because it's such a trusted platform. So rather than having to spend lots and lots of money on SEO and other techniques, you can actually show on the first page results for your business name just by getting a company page set up. So that's great. That's number one. Number two, it also allows all of your employees to build up their personal brands and tie back into your company, because they can update their work experience, and then all of a sudden your company logo shows up everywhere. So we start to build that team, you know, environment. So they're the really, really basic levels. So the other side is, obviously, you can keep building on that and taking it up the next level. And what I say to people is, if you want to get the most out of a company page, you've got to teach your employees and give them, you know, training on how to get the most out of LinkedIn. And then what you do is you use your company page to build up their personal brands, and you ask the employees to help build the company brand. And the more that you work together, the more that the benefits come through. So it's getting the synergies between use your company to build up your employees and make it easy for them to do their work, and then make sure you do it the other way around as well. So yeah, so there's lots of, you know, really great tools on company pages that you can use. But for me personally, it's just making sure that it does support your employees just as much.
Okay, thank you. Thank you for sharing that. Those are very, very good ideas here. But okay, I will take this 10 or 15 minutes. I will build this. What's next?
Excellent. So you're going to build it, okay? So once we build it, then we've got to have a strategy around what we do with it. So for people that are really time poor, and say you are never going to have any time to actually do anything, all I'm recommending is that you do one post on that page that shows people that if they happen to organically land on it by doing searches within LinkedIn or on other platforms for your business name, that you do one post that directs them in another direction on where they can best find you. So that's the number one thing that I would say. But we can get so much more out of it, you know, and the balance is, how do you put more in without, you know, taking over your whole life, you know, because people often have limited resources, as we said. So how do you do your personal brand and your company brand if you're not getting as many views and likes and, you know, things along those lines? So what I would say is, if you can manage it, one post per week is more than enough on a company page when you're starting out. So don't post every day. Don't try and do too much. Even if it's once a month, that's perfectly okay when you're starting out. It's something that I say, it's like brick by brick, we're building the house. You know, we don't have to do it all today. We just think about it for the long term. So what you want to do for a company page for it to be really effective is to make sure you're building up a community who are really, really interested in your products or service or what your business offers. Now, I don't know about you, but on my personal profile, I think I'm sitting on around 7,000 followers at the moment. The problem that I have is my business right now, I help people, you know, manage their company pages and give them training around company pages. But most of my contacts come from my old industry, which is the beauty industry and chemical distribution. Absolutely not aligned. There's nothing about the people in the beauty industry that want to know about company pages. There might be a few, but not the most. But if so, the 7,000, I might have, you know, you know, maybe 1,500 of them are actually interested. But if I come over onto my company page, I've specifically built that around either page administrators or people that are business owners that are interested in company pages specifically. So even though I only have 1,000 followers, they're all really interested in that topic. Mm-hmm. So when I'm doing my business development and fostering those relationships, I already know those people that are interested, which is super exciting.
I love those points, but how to get those followers there?
Yeah, so there's a couple of cool strategies. So each month, LinkedIn gives every company page 100 invite credits. And what an invite credit does is allows you to invite 100 people from your personal brand and your personal connections and invite them to follow the page. So every time you invite someone and they accept that invitation to follow the page, you get a credit back again so you can reuse it. Now, the cool thing that I'd like to share with your audience is if you want to make this super effective, make sure that you use the invite filters. Now, the filters allow you to choose where you're going to send out those invitations. So don't just do it to the first 100 that pop up. What I want you to do is go in and have a look and say, okay, if your business is only geography specific, so you only look after, in my case, I'm here in Sydney. So if I only look after Sydney, then use the filters to invite my personal connections from Sydney. Mm-hmm. There's other industry filters, and there's also, you know, a couple of other filters that you can use. So the more that you use those filters, the more likely you are to get a yes, and the more likely you get another invite credit. So you're going to do that. Now, the number of page followers that you're after is only between 500 and 1,000. So it's not this huge number. It's not going to take you 10 years to try and build it. You know, like quite often, most people have had LinkedIn accounts for such a long time. You know, we forgot what it was like to start building. But if you start with a company page, if you start using your invite credits and just be reasonably active, you'll get to that in about 6 to 9 months. Depending on how big your team is. So it's not a long time to invest. And once you've built it, it's there as an asset, you know, and if you, especially if you have plans at some stage in the future to sell your business or get other people into your business, if you're a solopreneur, it becomes an asset that you can actually share with other people. Because if we think about it, if I go to sell my business and I've built up all of the followers of my company on my personal brand, you can't sell that. It's not an asset. It goes with you, and we have that same problem again. So that's one way with the invite strategy. And the other way is content. Okay, so by making sure that you have really high quality and high value content, then you can actually make sure you're attracting the right audience. So using combinations of what we know works best on company pages. So a practical tip is use all different styles of content. So don't just do all text posts or all polls or all video, mix them up, because we find that we get the best response when we mix things up. So content and invite strategy, and asking your employees to obviously share with their connections as well, is another great way to make sure you can get the page to grow.
Okay, very good tips, very practical, invite and content and employees. So, okay, so now I have already followers, I built this community there. So next step would be to drive those conversations there.
And that's
how should we do that? Because we don't want to be like too pushy there, right? To sales it.
Yeah, and this is the thing, you know, we don't want to just collect them and not do anything with them. And we also don't want to just jump on them and try and sell. So the same applies on personal profiles. Mm-hmm. Company pages, when people follow a company page, there's almost an expectation that at some point you will offer something. And I look at it and say, what we're going to do is solve someone else's problems. Like, my business exists because there are people out there that want LinkedIn training or they want their company page managed. That, so there's a problem. So there's business owners out there, and it's about finding the match, you know, and making sure that we align. So when we're doing these kind of things, what I say to people is it's important to, if you have a salesperson within your team or sales function, make sure that they're actively involved, because we want them to reach out and also make connections and nurture relationships with page followers. You know, this is where we have that integration. One doesn't work without the other. You know, it's not something like when people say to me, oh, you're looking after it, you manage it, you know, you look after it, it'll be fine. It doesn't work like that. It works when you use my skills and combine them with, you know, the people within the business who are experts in their field. You know, I don't know, you know, the ins and outs of a business like the people within the business. So making sure that you've got the team involved is really important.
But what about the content there? Do you have some thoughts here? What are the best content to engage your audience?
Yeah, so I can actually give your audience a really easy strategy to remember so that when you're stuck for content ideas, the best content on company pages works like this. And this comes from LinkedIn. So it's a, you know, strategy directly from them, which I agree with. And so it's called the 3-2-1 strategy. Really easy to remember, right? So 3-2-1. So think about the number of posts is 6 in total over the period of 2 weeks. Mm-hmm. So if we were to do 3 posts per week over 2 weeks, and if you can't do it, you know, this much, then just spread it out, but, you know, rotate it like this. Mm-hmm. So 3 posts, concentrate on big picture. So what do you know about your industry? What's happening? What's impacting it? What's new? Mm-hmm. Where has it come from? What are the problems you foresee? What are the new technologies? So think really, really big picture. So that's what we would say is where people get to learn that you're, you know what's happening in your industry, that you're ahead of it, that you're a news, you know, outlet for all things in your industry. So think about it big picture. But if we keep doing just all big picture, boring. Okay, so company pages, if they're boring and don't entertain, people will run away from them. Mm-hmm. So we've got to be conscious of that. So if we move into the next step, I would say we need 2 posts in that 2-week period, which are feel-good posts. So we've gone from big picture 3 posts to feel good in 2 posts in this mm-hmm. 2 weeks. What's a feel good post? Behind the scenes photos. Absolutely, if you have a smartphone in your hand, that is the best source of content for LinkedIn company pages, hands down. So take photos of around the office, take photos of people in warehouses, the accounts team, if you're having employee milestones or birthdays, or, you know, maybe your business supports community activities. There's so much feel-good stuff within a business. When we start to see that, you get to see what the business stands for. You also get to have a sneak peek, you know, what's happening in that business that I can't find out on their website. So think about it like that. So then we have 1 post left in that 2 weeks. And that 1 post is often overlooked. And that's the one where we let people know what our products and services are and how it solves the problem of the people that are following the page. So not, you know, sometimes it could be a direct sale, but if you talk to the problem of the person on the other side and how your product or service solves that, and then that person goes, yes, I've been following, you know, your industry news. I really like the people that I've been watching, and I've seen that you look after your staff and you care about the community. What can you actually help? Because I don't have time, you know, in my case, my posts are written to people that don't have time to manage their own company pages, mm-hmm. you know, and so connecting those dots is often something that, you know, in the personal branding space, people say, oh, don't sell on LinkedIn. Well, actually, no, that's what we're here for, but just don't do it when you first meet someone, right? that's what we're actually saying. So, you know, don't forget to do that. So 3-2-1, big picture, feel good products and services.
Oh my God, those sounds like ninja tricks, you know, straight from LinkedIn.
It is, you know, because just keep it simple, right? Mm-hmm. And if you can't manage that much, then just spread it out, you know, but the theory is still the same. It's just gives people, so it's not too much of any one thing. So if it's all feel good, we don't think that you know about your industry, and we don't trust people, you know, and if it's all too much of products and services, mm-hmm. it's all sell, sell, sell. No one wants to listen to that. It's why we watch, you know, Netflix instead of TV with ads these days. Yeah. You know, we don't just want sell, sell, sell. So yeah, that's a really easy strategy for people to remember.
Oh my God. That's amazing. And another thing I see a lot is that people forget to talk about the products and services because they don't want to be salient, but they But the point really is that while you're building this trust there, people don't know what you're offering, right? That's a good reminder.
Yeah, and if absolutely. And if you don't, your competitor will, you know, mm-hmm. and often it's about, you know, with a company page, it's about being top of mind. Mm-hmm. So mm-hmm. I'm here to tell you, you will not get as many views, you will not get as many likes, you will probably not get as many comments. And what I'm here to tell people and challenge their assumptions is that it means that they're not working. And my theory is that, and I've seen it too many times, you know, in my experience, is I believe with company pages, people watch them to learn and they keep that information in their own head and they don't necessarily comment or like, but it's a, you know, what I find is they'll come back later and they say, we saw this post that you did. Mm-hmm. I'd be like, you know, when it's mine, I'm scratching my head going, you didn't like, you didn't comment. Why didn't you make me feel good? But what they did is they may have thought it was a competitive advantage by getting my services. They may not want their competitors to know that they mm-hmm. don't know that information. So, but it doesn't mean they're not watching. So it's important to keep that in mind with mm-hmm. Company pages. And the other trick that I give people for their content, make sure you ask a question in your posts. So invite people into the conversation. Don't mm-hmm. talk at them. It's such a good strategy, especially on company pages. Again, that's overlooked.
Use questions. Oh my God. Love it. So one more thing I'd like to ask from you, Michelle. What do you think of using this email in LinkedIn? How do you see that? You know, should it be something you use also or not?
Look, my personal opinion is I don't use it. So mm-hmm. my strategy on LinkedIn has always been around content. Mm-hmm. So I love to write, I love to create, and that's something that I've practiced over a long time. So I enjoy it. So for me, it's about commenting is more of a powerful strategy for me on other people's posts and seeing who comments on mine than send, you know, say for instance, doing searches and doing emails to people. Mm-hmm. So there are people that are very successful on that. I can see that LinkedIn's starting to really hold that back. So for instance, recently they've stopped us from, you know, being able to connect with lots and lots of people every week. So that number's been restricted down to around 100 connections per week, roughly. And if you do it too fast, you could end up in LinkedIn jail, as they say. So for me, you know, by having the company brands and then building the personal, mm-hmm. you can actually use them to really build your business, and you know, without having to go out into the emails. So that's mm-hmm. just for me personally.
That's very good, but I have this inner doubt that where should one business really build his community? Because if you remember, just a week ago, Facebook was down for 6 hours.
I know, right? Like, what did we all do? Look, that's a very valid point with any social media mm-hmm. platform. There's always a risk that if you have all your eggs in one basket, mm-hmm. that, you know, something will happen. So I take your point on that. And that's partly the reason why I, you know, also recommend having a company page and a personal profile. So you've got different, you know, levels of connections on both of those. Mm-hmm. I look at it as it's also an extra chance to show up in the news feed, you know, like, so I don't want to do multiple posts on my personal account because we know once we go past the first post, it doesn't have as much reach. But if I go my company page and my personal page, you're always going to see one or the other. You know, I've got more chance of showing up. So, you know, again, it just comes down to what's the overall business goal. And I think that's really important that before we take any actions on LinkedIn or any other social media platform, let's go back and find out what is it that your business is trying to achieve. Because quite often people skip over that step and then they do lots and lots of work and they're really, really busy on social media, going so fast down the wrong track mm-hmm. that all of a sudden they're like, it doesn't work, and they give up. And it's like, actually, it does work, but you've got to be laser focused or it's just distracting.
So it all starts with clarity, Michelle, right?
Absolutely. Clarity about your business mm-hmm. goals. Because, you know, for me, everything on LinkedIn has to support your business goals, you know, and drive. It's, you know, just a tool that you use to achieve your business goals. It's not something that you know, goes the other way around, where what you're doing on LinkedIn changes your business goals. You know, it should actually just be helping. So it's really important for me to make sure, you know, when I'm starting work with people, is like, what are you on here for? And if you can't tell me in a lot of detail, and we, you know, we can work together to do it, but if you can't tell me in a lot of detail, who is your ideal client? You know, like if you can't tell me that, just don't start on social media full stop. It doesn't matter the platform, because the more detail you can put around who your ideal client or customer is, the more that you can build out a system that talks to that person and the problems that they have. And that's where the success comes from. Trying to be everything to everyone, that fails miserably. It just makes you tired and wears you out.
I know. Oh my God. I love everything you have shared with us today. This is so practical, and that's especially what I love here. But please, Michelle, tell us, how should people get touch with you right now? I know people are listening to this interview and thinking, oh my God, I want to get to know Michelle's work more and more.
Yeah, look, I'd love it if they could come over and find me, obviously, on LinkedIn. So there's two places that you can find me. So my name is Michelle J Raymond. And the reason that I let everyone know about my middle initial is there's lots of really awesome Michelle Raymonds on LinkedIn. But there's only one Michelle J Raymond, which is why I have that initial in there, so I can stand out for you. The other place is my company called Good Trading Co. And Good Trading Co specializes in all things company pages. So the only content that I put out relates to company pages, and I actually, you know, test a lot of new features for LinkedIn directly. So you'll get to see those features rolled out to me first. So I make sure that everybody knows about them. So yeah, come and find me on LinkedIn. I really love to connect with everyone.
Amazing. Thank you so much, Michelle. So just to wrap up, you know, our listeners are most often overwhelmed business owners. Sometimes they're alone there and they really need some inspiration and they need to be empowered. So please share your empowering quote and a song you have chosen us.
So my song is a song called Higher Love, which is, you know, a remix of an old Whitney Houston song. And I love that because it's just uplifting. Like, you know, if you play that kind of music, it's all of a sudden just gives me energy. So from that side of things, you know, it's just my favorite, you know, tune that I recommend to people.
I love it. It yeah. will go to our list. Thank you.
Yay. I love that it'll be on there. So typically, you know, if I'm going to talk about quotes that I use, the normal one that I would use is something that my mom taught me when I was younger, but I didn't realize until much later. And she said, Michelle, if you hang out with garbage, you'll smell like it. And at the time she meant stop hanging out with the wrong crowd when I was, you know, a late teenager. But now I realize on LinkedIn, it's the opposite. If you, you know, really surround yourself with powerful people that are good at what they do and build yourself a community online to support your business growth, that is the best tool of LinkedIn that you will ever find. So thank you for letting me share.
Oh my God, that is truly inspiring. So is there any final thoughts or something you think our listeners need to hear before we go?
Yeah, there is. The one thing that I would say is if you are someone that tried company pages more than 12 months ago and it failed miserably, what I'd like you to do is go back and take another look, because LinkedIn has improved the functionality so much in the last 12 months. And the reason is that a lot of their revenue, so they're having records for ad spend on the platform, and you can't run ads without a company page. So we're actually getting the benefits of all this new ad spend because of COVID and everything that happened. So there's an upside. Company pages are getting new functions and features, and things like LinkedIn Lives to events on company pages are running, you know, really, really well. And, you know, from that side of things, just go back and have another look, you know, give them another go. And just when you look at the success, make sure we're looking at no less than 12 months. You know, like this is not something if you need a quick sale tomorrow, wrong product, wrong strategy. But if it's something that you have a business for the long term, look at your page in the long results in the long term as well.
Wow, that's a huge. I didn't know about that. Thank you, Michelle.
That's that's okay. Look, there's so many cool things that are coming for company pages. And especially like my secret tip just for your listeners is that if you are wondering what kind of content is going to perform best in the future for company pages, it's actually long form articles. So it moves away from short posts because there's so much rubbish out on the internet in long form blog posts that actually people are looking for good quality results. And so LinkedIn is a platform that's trusted. And so the more that you can invest in some really high quality, high value articles, you'll see a return on that.
But that brings me to videos. Should we post videos there too?
Yes. You know why? Because one of the advantages of company pages over personal profiles is every company page has a video tab. Mm-hmm. And so all of your videos display like a mini YouTube channel sitting on your company page. And they're really easy to find and they lay out really nicely. So if you've got, you know, video content floating around on your website, or maybe you've created it and posted it under your personal brand, repurpose it. Okay. Mm-hmm. So it's okay to reuse it and bring it across. Just don't hit the share button. That's the fake news of LinkedIn.
Oh my God. I could go on and on hours with you, but
because we said so we wouldn't.
But now I should go back and listen to the whole interview again. It's filled with those amazing tips and the very practical tips. So thank you, Michelle. Once again, it's been amazing talking to you. And I hope one day we can, I don't know, do it again, you know, because LinkedIn surely improves themselves. And you never know when we should come here and meet again, right?
Oh, absolutely. I would love to be your guest again. And congratulations on getting the podcast up and running. Woo-hoo. So that's just awesome.
Woo-hoo.
I love to celebrate those successes because I know that it's not easy to make these things happen. So congratulations.
I know. I appreciate it. Thank you, Michelle. Thank you.
No problem.
That's all we've got for this episode of the Powerful Marketing Tips podcast. Make sure to link up with us at our free monthly international mastermind event. Just go to powerful-marketers.com/mastermind for registration. And one thing that would really help us and other new potential listeners is if you would rate this show and leave a comment wherever you tune in to listen. Until next time, take care.